Why, oh why, would you bury a brand new Ford popular motor in your backyard? This is exactly what someone has done, much to the current occupant's surprise and confusion, as no apparent conclusion can be drawn. Maybe it was a stolen car and the thief didn't want to get caught. Maybe it was part of some sinister murder case, or maybe it was a time traveler who put it there for safekeeping. Whatever the case, maybe it's a weird one, that's for sure. John Brayshaw, who lives in Yorkshire, thought he would fix up the garden during lockdown. Discovered this in the middle of his garden and is now appealing for more information to try to reveal the circumstances as to why a 70-year-old motor was buried here, probably shortly after the automobile's production from the assembly line. Buried complete with engine and registration plates, John says he would love to get it out of the hole or even find out how it got there and why. John says, "It's just so weird why it's down there. The car is intact and you can still see the gray color it was painted. I'd love to be able to get the car out, but I don't think it's possible by hand." Perhaps it was a former militarized vehicle, and maybe there is more than one buried down there. We just thought it was an interesting little tale to bring you guys during this time. Ford produced this vehicle in England between 1953 and 62, and it is thought that there would be at least one of these models on every street in England during this time, as it was the working man's car. The car was very basic. It had a single vacuum power wiper, no heater, vinyl trim, and very little chrome. Even the bumpers were painted, and the backlight dash of the Anglia was replaced by a flat steel panel. The popular 103E differed visually from the Anglia E494E in having smaller headlights and a lack of trim on the side of the bonnet, or hood as we call it here in the States, and was affordable to families on a budget. But how did this particular one become buried in this guy's backyard? What do you guys consider when thinking about these circumstances? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.